Hello everybody. In this session, we will derive the ABCD parameters of medium transmission line using nominal pi method. Nominal pi method is also known as a split condenser method because capacitance is divided in half. Half of the capacitance is situated at the receiving end, half is the situated at the sending end. So this is the per phase circuit diagram of nominal pi method. So as you can see here, Vs is the per phase sending end voltage, Vr is the per phase receiving end voltage, Is is the per phase sending end current, Ir per phase receiving end current, Ics is the per phase capacitance current that will flow through this C by 2. Similarly, Icr is the capacitor current that will flow through the C by 2 which is situated at the receiving end. R and X are the resistance and reactance of each conductor, that is per phase resistance and inductive reactance. Capacitances are also of per phase basis. Capacitance will have an admittance which is given by Y. As this is C by 2, here it is written as Y by 2. Similarly, as this is C by 2, this will also be Y by 2. Admittance will be Y by 2. Z is the series impedance of transmission line. Now, as we know, for series RL network, impedance Z, it will be given as R plus JX, and admittance Y, it is given by J times BC for pure capacitance, where BC is the capacitive susceptance which is reciprocal of inductive reactance. So BC is 1 upon XC, and as we know XC is 1 over omega C, so therefore BC will be omega into C. So Y will be equal to J omega C, or in terms of frequency it will be J 2 pi F C. Now we need to derive the ABCD parameters of transmission line. Now we know the standard form of equations to express Vs, Is in terms of Vr, Ir in form of ABCD. These are given in equation 1 and 2. Vs is AVr plus BIr, Is equal to CVr plus DIr. So we have to express Vs and Is in terms of Vr and Ir. Now first we will represent Vs in terms of Vr and Ir. So how we can do that? So we can apply KVL to this mesh to obtain equation of Vs. Now what will be Vs now? If I apply KVL to mesh, applying KVL, that is Kirchhoff's voltage law to mesh, so what we will get? Vs equal to Vr plus I1 into Z. Let us call this as equation number 3. Vs equal to Vr plus I1Z. Now here as you can see we have Vr but we don't want I1. So how we can express I1 or how we can eliminate this I1? Now see this, if I apply KCL at this particular node, then I can express I1 in terms of ICR and IR. And ICR I can express in terms of VR. Okay, so let me call this as node W. So applying KCL at node W, KCL is Kirchhoff's current law to node W. So what we can write? Incoming current, it is I1 equal to outgoing current, that is IR plus ICR. Equation number 4. What is ICR here? ICR is the current that is flowing through this C by 2. By Ohm's law we can write this current as voltage across this C by 2 which is VR into Y by 2. Okay, so by Ohm's law ICR is equal to VR into Y by 2. Basic Ohm's law is current equal to voltage upon impedance, and 1 upon impedance we can represent as admittance. Okay, now we can put this value in equation number 4. So we will get I1 equal to IR plus VR into Y by 2. Okay, let us call this as equation number 5. Now here this I1 consists of only IR and VR terms, there is no other term. Now we can put equation 5 in equation 3. Now putting equation 5 in equation 3. So what we will get, Vs equal to Vr as it is plus I1 is nothing but Ir plus Vr into y by 2 into z. Okay, so if you simplify this, Vs will be equal to 1 plus zy by 2 into Vr plus z into Ir. Okay, Vr we can take common. So Vr into bracket 1 plus zy by 2 plus zir. So this will be equation number 6. As you can see, this equation does not contain any other term apart from Vr and Ir. So we can compare this equation 6 with equation 1. We will get A and B. But we also require Is. Now how we can express Is? Now see here, we can apply KCL at this node to express Is. So Is will be I1 plus ICS, and we will eliminate this ICS and I1. Now let us call this node as say L. Okay, I will call that node as node L. So applying KCL, Kirchhoff's current law at node L. Now what we can write, Is equal to I1 plus ICS. Okay, let us call this as equation number 7. Now what is I1? So already I1 we have obtained from equation 5. Okay, so that is in terms of IR and VR. So I1 we know, but what is ICS? ICS is the current flowing through this C by 2. So by Ohm's law, ICS will be voltage across this C by 2, that is Vs into Y by 2. Okay, so by Ohm's law, ICS will be equal to Vs into Y by 2. Okay, but what is Vs? So already we have determined that in equation number 6. Okay, so from equation 6, ICS will be equal to Y by 2 into Vs. And what is Vs? If I simplify this, if I multiply Vr inside, so I will get this term. Okay, now what will be ICS now? It will be Y by 2 Vr plus Z Y square by 4 Vr plus Z Y by 2 Ir. Okay, this is next equation, equation number 8. Now what we can do here, we can put equation number 8 and equation number 5 in equation number 7. Okay, now putting equation 5 and 8 in equation 7. Putting equation 5 and 8 in equation 7. Okay, so let me take a new page here. So Is will be equal to I1. I1 is Ir plus Vr into Y by 2 plus ICS, which is Y by 2 Vr plus Z Y square by 4 Vr plus Z Y by 2 Ir plus Z Y by 2 Ir. Okay, so what we have done, basically we have substituted equation number 5 and equation number 8 in equation number 7. Okay, now which term we can take common here? Now you can see here there is a Y Vr, so Y by 2, Y by 2 it will be Y, and it will be z y square by 4. From that we can take y common. So Is will be y into bracket 1 plus z y by 4 Vr plus, now here there is a IR and here there is a IR. So we can take IR common. Now if I take IR as a common, then what I will get? 1 plus ZY by 2 IR. Okay, that is the next equation. It will be equation number 9. Okay, so I will rewrite equation number VS, that is VS equation is equation number 6. So from equation 6 I will rewrite so that we can compare with standard equation. So from equation 6 VS is equal to 1 plus ZY by 2 VR plus ZIR. Okay, this is equation number 6. Now we can compare these equations with the standard equation. What is the standard equation? Vs is AVR plus BIR, Is is CVR plus DIR. So comparing equation 6 and 9 with equation 1 and 2 respectively, 1 and 2 respectively. So what we will get? We will get our ABCD parameters. So what will be A? So this is nothing but A. A is 1 plus ZY by 2. B is Z. C is Y into bracket 1 plus ZY by 4. And D is 1 plus ZY by 2. Okay, so these are the final ABCD parameters of medium transmission line, which is solved by using the nominal pi method. Okay, we can also rewrite these equations in matrix form. We can write equation 6 and 9 in matrix form. So writing equations 6 and 9 in matrix form. So what we will get is Vs Is equal to 1 plus ZY by 2 ZY into 1 plus ZY by 4 1 plus ZY by 2 into VR IR. Okay, let us call it as equation number 10. Okay, now we can check whether our answers are correct or not. So how we can check? We can compare the units. If I compare the units, so A and D should be unitless. So whether we are getting unitless here, as you can see, unit of Z and Y, it will get cancelled. So it will be a number. So A is unitless. Similarly, D will be unitless. Okay, so A and D are unitless. So that we are getting. Next, B should have a unit of ohm. So that is true because B is impedance. Impedance unit is ohm. C should have unit of Siemens. Now here, as you can see, Z and Y unit will get cancelled. Units of Z and Y will get cancelled. Only Y will be left. So C will have a unit of Siemens. So our values are correct. So B, it should have a unit of ohm. C should have a unit of Siemens. Okay, so that is one thing. Now, as you can see, our given network, this network is symmetrical as well as reciprocal. Okay, and if network is symmetrical, A should be equal to D. Okay, so I will write network is symmetrical. So network is symmetrical means A should be equal to D. Now whether we are getting A is equal to D? Yes, because A and D both are equal, and which is equal to 1 plus ZY by 2. Okay, so for network, as network is symmetrical, we are getting this condition, and also network is reciprocal. So nominal pi method, network is reciprocal. So if network is reciprocal, condition that should be fulfilled is AD minus BC should be 1. Now we will check whether AD minus BC is 1. If I take product of A into D, then 1 plus ZY by 2 into 1 plus ZY by 2. So that will be 1 plus ZY by 2 square minus BC. If I take BC, B into C, so it will be YZ into bracket 1 plus ZY by 4. Now what is A plus B whole square? It is A square plus 2AB plus b square minus yz minus z square y square by 4. Okay, so this term will get cancelled, zy will get cancelled, so we will left with 1. Okay, so our second condition is also fulfilled, ad minus bc is equal to 1 as network is reciprocal and as network is symmetrical, a is equal to d. Okay, so these are the ABCD parameters of nominal pi method. Okay, now once we determine ABCD parameter, we can substitute these values in equation number 1 and 2 to determine sending end voltage, sending end current. Similarly, we can determine sending end power factor, voltage regulation as well as transmission efficiency. Okay, so once ABCD parameters are determined, we can determine other transmission line parameters. Okay, so I hope you understood how to determine the ABCD parameters of transmission line, medium transmission line, using nominal pi method. Thank you. So if you have not subscribed to the channel, so do subscribe the channel for all the latest updates. Thank you.